You know that feeling when you're just about done with your studio and you don't need to buy anything else? Yeah, I don't know that feeling either. So,
hi, welcome to the Midlight Synthesis. Let's get started.
So first off, I'd like to say that this is a really exciting machine. No pun intended. So I'm pretty sure most of you are familiar with the Machina MK3. It was never a direct competitor to the MPC or the Octatrack, since it was always hooked up to a computer. And I tried it a few years back, and I actually really liked it. And I remember thinking way back, wouldn't it be awesome to have the Machina and all the complete libraries just available to you on a standalone mode with full portability without having to hook up to a laptop? Here it is, Machina Plus, a new standalone version of the Machina MK3 MIDI controller and software. I don't know about you, but as soon as I started seeing pictures of this and the videos, my gas meter just went way up. But then after the initial excitement, I started really looking into this, you know, seeing the specs of what it can do and what it's offering. And I have to say, this isn't quite the Machina standalone that I was expecting. Let me explain. First of all, the things that I really like about it. It's a well-known, mature software paired up with a great MIDI controller from a really respectable brand. This version is standalone, you don't have to hook it up to a computer, and that's really cool because it takes the Machina environment and puts it in DAWless territory, which is something that we all really wanted for a long time. The interface itself is pretty cool. It's got loads of dedicated buttons, those endless rotator knobs, that 4D switch knob button thing. It's got two top-notch, extremely good quality screens, but they're not touch screens, which is something that I'm going to touch on later. I've said this before, I'm a really huge fan of loads of dedicated buttons and knobs on the front panel, because that's the only way that you can really develop a muscle memory, where you don't have to go menu diving and you don't have to remember where the option is, your hands just remember the way. And that's the only way, to me at least, to get a really fast workflow. Perhaps one of the biggest selling points of the Machina are its plugins. Now I'm pretty sure that most people watching this channel have at least heard about Native Instruments, and probably have used one or more of their plugins. Let's just say that the sounds that you can get on most of these software synths put that digital versus analog debate to rest. Already included in the standalone are the Monarch, the Prism, the Reactor, the Massive, and the wonderful FM8 synth. And I just have to say that the possibility of having all those software synths and the possibility of adding new ones in the future at your fingertips without the need of a computer, now that's pretty hot. You also get an SD slot, so you can expand your memory up to 1 TB using an SD card. In regards to horsepower, I haven't been able to find out which CPU exactly it uses, but I imagine it should be enough to accommodate the VSCs that you'll be using. Also, it boasts 4 GB of RAM, a lot more than my 2 GB on the MPC and way more than on the Octatrack or the Digitect. Now finally, versatility-wise, this can function as an audio interface. Be it all that, it's a pretty basic one, but you also get 2 USB ports to further expand its capabilities. As a side note, I've always found that the Machina MK3 is just beautiful. I love the look of it, it looks like something from the future. I'm not really sure about that brushed aluminium on the new model, but I guess you'll get used to it. So first off, I think the lack of integrating a touchscreen on this standalone device might have been a big oversight, especially because the piano roll is just this tiny little thing. And sure, when you use the Machina MK3 on a computer, you could just adjust it with a mouse. But on a fully standalone machine, I think that editing on that piano roll and trying to automate the lanes on this is going to be an absolute nightmare. Second, the audio interface on this thing is pretty bare bones. I mean, you don't even get an XLR input, so I assume you won't get any phantom power either. Also, let's not forget that you won't get any CV outs here, and there are cheaper alternatives with CV outs. Also, Machina users have been begging for a proper timeline for quite a while. Hopefully, this will be addressed in a new update. Now, all these things that I've mentioned might be seen as nitpicking. I mean, we've been asking for a standalone Machina for quite a while. And you know what? I would be willing to look past all of that. There's just one thing that I think that Native Instruments got completely wrong, and that is the price. There's just no way that this thing should cost $1,400. Now sure, you might say, wait a minute, the MPC Live costs about $1,200. The Octatrack is like $1,500, so how come the Machina is overly priced? That doesn't make sense. Now, if you bear with me for just a few minutes, I'll try to explain why I think that the pricing on the Machina just makes absolutely no sense at all. For this little analysis, I'd like to break down our music community into 3 little groups. First off, we're gonna have our complete beginners, people with absolutely no experience, looking to dive in headfirst into this beautiful world of beat making. Then, we're gonna have our experienced beat makers, and we're going to divide those into 2 groups, experienced Machina users and experienced non-Machina users. Now I'm assuming that the people on all of these groups want a computer-free standalone system, because if not, they really should be looking at the Machina MK3. So first category, absolute beginners. So if you're just starting out and you have absolutely no gear, for $1,400 you're pretty much getting a very basic audio interface, a great audio library, and some pretty cool VSTs, an excellent MIDI controller, and that's about it. You're blowing a huge amount of cash on something that'll get you just halfway there. Seriously, if you're just starting out, I really would recommend not ditching the computer right at the start. I mean, a little knowledge about DAWs and plugins can get you a long way and can really help educating you so you can use hardware stuff more easily. That being said, and if you don't mind the computer, you're better off buying the Machine MK3 and maybe a DAW like Logic Pro. And even after buying both of those things, you'll still probably have enough money to buy a good decent pair of headphones or maybe a nice key controller like the Keystep. On the other hand, if you really decided to ditch the computer, the obvious choice here, for me at least, is the MPC-1. It's half the price and it has basically the same functionality. Also, you get a touchscreen, a much smaller format, which means it's way more portable. And finally, you get the CV outs, which means you could go modular in the long run. And let's not forget, for the price of the Machina Plus, you could buy the MPC-1 and a pretty decent hardware synth like the Make Noise O-Coast. And you'll even have the CV outs to control that thing. As a final thought on why I don't think this as a standalone would be a good choice for a beginner is I really don't like piano rolls on something that doesn't have a touchscreen or a mouse. So if you're an absolute beginner and you have to edit on that little piano roll just using the knobs, you're gonna have a bad time. As a side note, maybe a really cool thing that Native Instruments could make to help fix this is making a companion app, you know, something for your smartphone or your tablet, and that way you could edit the piano roll on a touchscreen, kind of like the Logic Remote. Now that would be sweet. So in the second category, you get experienced non-Machina users. Now, for people who already own an MPC, or an Octatrack, I honestly don't think that there's much here on display to justify the purchase. In my mind at least, if you already own an MPC, the competitive edge on the Machina is really the sound libraries and the VSTs. And let's not fool ourselves, that is a pretty big edge. I mean, I really like the synths that come in the MPC, but I'm not gonna compare it to Native Instruments synths. I mean, those are just top of the line. However, is that worth $1,400? I don't think so. If you disagree, by all means, go and buy that. But let's not forget, you could just buy Complete for about half the price and just use it on your computer and control it with the MPC, which is not a bad option. Personally, I bought the Complete library ages ago and it's not collecting dust, you know, because it's a software program, but if it was physical, it would be collecting dust because I haven't used it in about, I don't know, a year and a half. I'm not saying they're useless or they're bad, they're actually extremely good. It's just that once you go DAWless, there's no going back. So if you're anything like me and you're used to the MPC workflow, I'm not sure there's much there to justify a switch. Finally, category 3. Experienced Machina users. Now, I think it's pretty safe to say that this is probably the group that will find the Machina Plus most attractive. At least I know that when I was using Machina, I really, really wanted a standalone version of that product. I mean, how awesome is it to have this software MIDI controller that you already know and love, and now you get to use it without having to hook up to a computer? But that's exactly why I'm saying that the pricing on this thing just makes no sense. If the biggest selling point on this machine is the software, why would you make it so expensive for people who already own that software? In all fairness, this would be a completely different video if this thing had come with an internal battery, or a touchscreen, or more ins and outs. But as it stands, it's pretty much the same Machina MK3, just that instead of having to hook it up to your computer, you have to hook it up to a wall. So ironically, the biggest competitor to the Machina Plus is Native Instruments' own Machina MK3, which if you already know and love, you probably already own as well. So I think it's pretty sad because this was a big opportunity to present something new, a real contender to the DAWless world. I really don't want to come off as an MPC or an Octatrack fanboy. I've always loved the idea of being able to use all my VSTs in a standalone format. I really hope that they bring the price down, because this thing, at a more sensible price, could be a real game changer. I think this kind of competition ultimately benefits us as the users. I mean, this thing will definitely make Akai get off their butts and start making new stuff for their MPC hardware. Who knows, maybe we might see something new from Electron, something like an Octatrack MK3? And maybe this is a good time to remind ourselves there will always be a new shiny music making box in the horizon, and that that perfect piece of gear just doesn't exist, and that maybe it's okay to not always have the latest thing that comes out. In the end, it's just you, your creativity, your passion, the love you put into your work. Not the name on the box that you're pushing the buttons on. That's what makes the difference. I hope you found this video useful, or at least entertaining. I hope to see you in the next one. Have a great day.